Hi, welcome to Product Review by Robojax. In this video, we are going to do the test and review of this PeaceFire PZEM501 100 ampere DC power meter. And we are going to use this 100 ampere 75 millivolt shunt and also 50 ampere 75 millivolt shunt. The voltage across this using this measuring instrument, my DAC, to measure DC current. Let's get started with this. Many application you need to measure over 10 ampere current. In many application you need to measure the current above 10 ampere, which most of the multimeter can handle. For example, in battery charging, in solar application, in power electronic, and this is one of the options that is sold on eBay and AliExpress. The model is PZEM051. This can show up to 100 ampere and operating voltage is 6.5 to 100 volts, 75 millivolts. 100 ampere shunt resistor included with this kit. When you receive it, also you will have this English Chinese manual. That's a plus for this. It has a backlight. For example, now it shows the voltage is 7 volt, the current is 10 ampere, and this is the power, and this is the energy watt hours that is being consumed when the device was on. If this device blinks, one of the wire is off. So I have to connect. I have this push button here that you can push it with a screwdriver to turn it on and off. And if you want this energy to be resetted, you can hold this until you see CLR on the screen. Clear. And now if I press it again, the energy have been cleared. So this is the first thing. And also for certain voltage, you can set a voltage. Let's say the voltage goes above 20, it should just give you warning or the blinking. So you press this and hold it and you will see set. Now you are setting the voltage here. Now if it goes to the next one, if I press it, I can change it or just wait, it goes to the next blink. Now it's at 91. From 6 to 91. As you can see, this is 50 ampere 75 millivolts, and this is 100 milliampere 75 millivolts. We are going to test both of these two different types. This can accept 50 ampere 75 millivolts or 100 ampere 75 millivolts. Let's set it, press and hold until you see CR, which is current. No, I missed that. That was clear. Press and hold until you see CR. Now it's current. So if I press this, we go to 50 ampere and we will use 50. And if you want 100, it will be 100 ampere. 100, just 100 ampere and wait. Within a few seconds, it just disappears and 100 is set. And on this side, except the display and switch, we don't have any other components. And this is a 2N60C 600 volts MOSFET. So on. There is also a diode that protects it in case you connect the polarity reverse. That's very good. So you don't have to worry if you connect the negative and positive in reverse. And this is a K24C02. This is a two-wire serial EEPROM. Here is the data sheet. This is the model that is used. The chip that holds the settings like energy consumption, type of shunt resistor, and other information. I'll provide you the link. This chip is the display driver for the screen. This is the chip, and here is the chip. It's called MXM11P62. I was not able to find any information about this. Here is the wiring for my power supply. The two wire that comes, these are my power supply. And this is the shunt for the current measurement. These are my two wires that goes to the load. This is the electronic load, DL3031. And these are the two terminals that from the circuit will be connected in here. And we will see the voltage here and the current.
The negative, now it's not tighten, I will tighten it.
the negative goes through this shunt resistor, and from here this goes to load. Two are going to the load and those two are going to power supply. Just put in between one of the line this shunt resistor. From this I have two wires to get the voltage across this, and these two will be connected into these two as shown in this diagram. These two wires are for the shunt resistor here. From this side this is positive and negative. I put a red and blue wire. The blue is connected to this side because this is my negative from power supply and this goes to the load. The positive is connected on this side. And here for the power supply you use these two tiny wires here, and these two are, and the positive is on this side. Pay attention, I put red. And you can connect a voltage above 6.5 volts, and if your source is 6.5 volts connected in here, otherwise you have to supply your own separate power supply, because if you are working with 5 volts or less, then connect separate power supply. And these two wires that I have here are connected in here. Negative is connected to the negative of power supply, and here is a positive. I am attaching it to my positive. Let me start the test. As you can see, this is now showing 7.07, and here my electronic load of Rigel DL3031 shows 7.075. This is more precise, and the current is here zero, and also we can see the current zero. I can set the current here by punching the number and turning on and off. Actual physical load is already here. It's just on the screen so we can see it and record it. I will turn it on. Now this is showing 10.03 while the current is 10 ampere at 6.9 volts. This can handle up to 100 ampere. And let me just go here. Here now the cursor is. Let me just increase the current. Let me go for 20. Now 20 ampere is being drawn via the load, and here is this shunt. Let me go for higher current. Let's make it 40. Now I set it at 40 ampere. As you can see, it shows 41.24 discrepancy, as you can see. The shunt resistor is very cool, absolutely like room temperature. Here the power that this one shows 287, and this is the power that we are reading, 266. It shows the total energy that has been consumed. I'm going now 50 and pressing OK. Now the current is 50. We are drawing 50 ampere from my power supply to the load. Now let's go for 60 amp. I've set it to 60 ampere and turn on. It shows 387 watt. This shows 427 watts. And also the current shows 62.5 while the current actually is 60 ampere exactly, 6.45 volts. Now let me measure the voltage across this and do the calculation of ourselves to see how accurate this is. This is now on voltage. First let's measure the voltage, the source. 6.77. Let's measure the voltage across the shunt resistor at 60 ampere. 50.3 millivolts. 50.3 millivolts. Now I have connected the 50 ampere shunt, 75 millivolts, and I've set the voltage. The voltage is below the value and it is now blinking. Now let's test it with 50 ampere shunt and 50 ampere current. As you can see, now it shows 51 amp. The amount of current that this shows has increased slowly because this has heat up, or maybe this element has heat up, but the system is drawing 50 ampere. This National Instrument device is now connected. I will measure the voltage across this shunt resistor using these two probes, and it's connected via USB, so you can see it on the screen. Now let's measure the voltage and see what is the voltage across this in here. As you can see, it shows 74.9, which is very correct, 75 millivolts per 50 ampere. So the shunt is working perfectly, and this is the discrepancy of mismeasurement of the device that does not measure properly. Let's measure 5 ampere. Now this is 5 amp, 5.1219. Now this is 5 amp, 5.1219. Now let's go for 2 amp. 2.09, 2.00, still 90 milliampere difference. 1 amp, 1.05, 50 milliampere, and this is 2 milliampere difference. Let's go 0.5. Now we are at 0.5, 30 milliampere difference. Now let's go to 0.1, see if it can display. 1. Thank you for watching. This was the test and review of PeaceFare PZEM051 power meter. If you like this video and learn something from it, please thumb up. I appreciate it. Please leave the notification on and also subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos.